To turn on the captions, find this button and select the language. As a winter maintenance professional, part of your job is to shovel snow and apply salt during the winter months. You are very important to keeping our community safe on the icy sidewalks of winter. Not only do you protect our campus, but you also help to make sure excess salt isn't washing into our rivers, streams, lakes, and filtering into our groundwater, which is the same water that we drink every day.
I think it's very important to do a good job on snow removal for many reasons. One is for the safety of our customers. That's really kind of the whole reason we do snow removal, to prevent slips and falls and allow people to get to where they are. We also want to protect our own people from slips and falls, and we also want to protect the environment. I think part of that is using the proper amount of salt or sand in the proper places so that we're mindful of the environment.
We applied de-icer over a lot of different impervious surfaces in the winter, so parking lots, roads, sidewalks, and as soon as that salt, usually, is hit with water, it dissolves and it goes anywhere the water goes. So in this case, it runs into storm sewers and straight into our lakes. In Wisconsin, we have a lot of fresh water, and as we start to have salt runoff from de-icers pollute those lakes, the concentration of salt starts increasing. And you can think of it like you think of yourself. If you eat too much salt, it's bad for you. We need fresh water to drink and to survive, and sort of the organisms that live in the lake. So as we start increasing those salt concentrations, it starts hurting anything that lives and has evolved to live in fresh water. So there's a lot of different terms we use when we're talking about winter de-icers. Often, the winter de-icers are mostly salt, and that salt can come in a lot of different forms, but often it's sodium chloride, which is the same salt that we eat. So we have sodium and chloride, and when those hit water, those both dissolve. And we often measure the chloride because it's not taken up by anything in the environment, and it's just a really good indicator of that pollution. And the problem for humans really is that the lake is connected to our groundwater, and we're seeing our groundwater concentrations of salt increase as well, which means our drinking water is getting saltier. So the good thing about chloride and sort of salt pollution in general is that it's definitely a solvable problem. It dissolves in water, and so as the lake flushes out, the concentrations will decrease. And so for us to lower the concentration of salt in our water, all we need to do is stop putting it in. It's really that simple.
Too much salt, which might also be called de-icer, is unhealthy for the environment, but it can also affect buildings and equipment. You might have seen rust spots on trucks and tools and harm to doorways, rugs, and flooring.
There are a lot of challenges that we face when it snows. We do have a lot of snow removal that's done by hand and essentially by shovels and brooms, etc.
The key to keeping sidewalks clear in the winter is to manually remove as much snow and ice as you can using shovels and brooms before you think about applying salt. Using salt on top of snow just creates ice or slush, which you'll have to clean up later. Also, clearing the snow before using salt allows you to use less salt to get the job done well. Small spaces are important to clear because many people walk through them every day. For small spaces, first try using a broom to keep the snow cleared off your surfaces. For a heavier snow, use a shovel. There are many different kinds of shovels, but the two we use are just a regular snow shovel and a push shovel. The regular shovel has small sides that help to keep the snow on the shovel. They're good for lifting and moving snow elsewhere. They're also good for working in small, tight quarters. The push shovel has no sides, and they're good for guiding or sliding the snow on the ground. Generally, you can move more snow faster with a push-type shovel. Weather in the winter can be very different every day. So when working outdoors, dress in layers. Wear a hat and gloves in addition to thermal underwear to help keep water away from your skin. Make sure to take short indoor breaks when you feel like you need to warm up. As you know, shoveling is hard work. It helps to keep your body in line and your work in front of you. Also, make sure to shovel snow with your knees bent. Another challenge is clearing snow during a snowfall or snowstorm. When people walk on the sidewalks, the snow can become compacted and is harder to remove. The trick is to start mechanical snow removal early, right when it starts snowing. Then work all through the storm. Clearing snow throughout the storm will stop snow from compacting. Temperatures usually drop after a storm, and sidewalks can become so cold that salt cannot work properly. Using more salt when it is cold isn't going to work. If you need to clear compacted snow or ice, use an ice chisel or an ice scraper. The chisel and scraper can be used to break through the ice and then scrape it away. Just be careful when using chisels not to damage the sidewalk and steps.
So often, if we get out early, we can shovel and remove ice, and that takes care of a lot of the problem. Obviously, salt is necessary in certain circumstances, you know, when it's really icy out, but a little salt goes a long way. And so there's proper sort of salting patterns that you can use where you really only need a cup of salt to cover, you know, a pretty large section of sidewalk or road. And so we really can reduce our salt use by, you know, just using less.
So how much salt should you use? Here's a simple way to look at it. A coffee mug of salt is enough to treat an entire 20-foot driveway, or 10 sidewalk squares. So if your area is about 5 sidewalk squares, use a half a coffee cup. If it is more like 20 sidewalk squares, use 2 coffee cups of salt. If you can't estimate the size of a certain space, make sure that you are spreading the salt so that there are no overlapping pieces. The pieces should be no more than 3 inches apart. You rarely need the salt spread more densely than this. A little salt goes a long way, so you only need to reapply in special circumstances, such as when snow is continually melting and refreezing. Check with your supervisor for when and where to reapply salt. Other weather conditions will affect how and when you apply salt. If it's a warm day and the sidewalk or steps look wet, you don't need to apply salt because the sun is doing the melting. If it is an average winter day, salt will work fine to melt ice. But on a very cold below zero day, salt may not work. To decide what salt to use, you need to consider the temperature of the air and the temperature of the pavement. If the sun is out, it can warm up the pavement so the ground can be warmer than the air. Sodium chloride, also known as rock salt, is in brands like Iceaway Turbo. This works for an average day, but will not melt the ice if it is below 15 degrees. Magnesium or calcium chloride is in brands such as Pelado Calcium Chloride. This works at colder temperatures, but won't work below negative 5 degrees. If you are using a blended de-icer, you will need to read the bag for application instructions or ask your supervisor for assistance to figure out when to use it. Wisconsin Saltwise provides an easy-to-use application calculator that allows you to enter the pavement temperature and the type of salt you are using. Then it'll tell you how much to use. If you want to help the rest of your crew, take the time to figure out the square footage of your entrances and draw on the scoop or cup how much salt is needed for that specific small space. Make sure to keep the salt fresh and spreadable. Store it in a tightly covered container because many de-icers attract moisture and turn into a solid lump if we keep them uncovered. If you have applied too much salt or if you spilled some, take a minute and sweep it up and reapply it to a different slippery area. If you leave extra salt on the concrete, you now have a new slippery situation, not to mention harming the water and nearby vegetation. You are very important in noticing problems in your maintenance area. You might notice problems like a dip in the sidewalk, where water collects and freezes every night, or water dripping from a roof and freezing on the steps. These are hazards for public safety, and you can't fix them no matter how much salt you use. Make others aware of the problem and report them to your supervisor.
This problem of chloride pollution into water is really at this nexus of trying to maintain public safety while at the same time being really environmentally friendly. And so there's probably some middle ground where we can use a lot less salt and maintain public safety while still trying to protect our freshwater resources.
If we make sure to physically remove snow and ice before applying salt, the salt will work better. Once the surface is cleared, make sure to follow the proper spread pattern and we'll be able to keep extra salt out of the lakes and rivers. Thank you for doing the hard work and keeping our community safe in the winter.